the devoted student. Once there was a boy named Aruni. He was a student of sage Dhaumya and lived in his ashram. One day it was raining heavily and Aruni was returning to the ashram after collecting firewood. While he was crossing the field, he saw that at the far end a barrier had been built to protect the crops by stopping water from entering the fields. But there was a gap in the barrier and water was leaking through it. He became worried and tried to put some mud and straw in the gap. But the pressure of the water was so strong that it washed away the mud. Meanwhile, in the ashram, sage Dhaumya was worried. So he set out to look for Aruni along with other students. They called Aruni's name and heard a faint reply. They reached the spot and found Aruni lying against the gap to stop the water leakage. He was shivering with cold. Sage Dhaumya was very happy to see his act of devotion. He took Aruni back to the ashram and made him feel warm and comfortable. He declared that he would be famous far and wide for his act of devotion. The Accursed Ketaki. One day, Lord Vishnu and Lord Brahma started quarreling about which of them was superior. Just then, Shiva appeared beside them in the form of an endless column of light. The column stretched upwards and downwards as far as the eye could see. The two gods decided that whoever found the top or the bottom of the column first would be superior. So Lord Vishnu, in the form of a boar, went far downwards but could not find the base of the column and finally gave up. Lord Brahma, in the form of a swan, flew upwards, but he too was unsuccessful in reaching the top. He saw a Ketaki flower falling down. He caught it and returned to the starting point to meet Lord Vishnu. Then, claiming his success, he waved the flower, which he said he had found at the top. Lord Vishnu asked the flower if Brahma was true. The flower of the column replied that Lord Brahma was true. This lie angered Lord Shiva and he cursed the flower. The Ketaki, till then considered the best among flowers, lost its importance and was never again offered in worship except on Mahashivratri, when it makes a shy appearance. River Kaveri. Once there was unusually hot summer prevailing in South India. Therefore, Sage Agastya went to Mount Kailash to ask Lord Shiva for water. The Kaveri was worshipping Lord Shiva at that time. Shiva picked her up and handed her to Agastya. The sage put her in his kamandalu pot. Sage Agastya thanked Lord Shiva for his priceless gift and set out for his journey to South India. Indra, the king of God, did not like what Lord Shiva had done. So he requested Lord Ganesha to go to Sage Agastya and somehow overturn his kamandalu so that Kaveri might flow out. Ganesha took the form of a crow and approached Sage Agastya. On his way, Sage Agastya was tired and sat down to take a rest. He kept the kamandalu down. Ganesha flew downwards and sat on the rim of the kamandalu. As a result, the kamandalu was overturned and the Kaveri flowed out. Sage Agastya was very angry with the crow. But as soon as Lord Ganesha transformed to his true form, Sage Agastya forgot his anger and calmed down. Lord Ganesha refilled Agastya's kamandalu, but the Kaveri flowed on. The river continues to flow in India even today. Prahlada, the great devotee. Hiranyakashyap and Hiranyakashyap were cruel demon brothers. Lord Vishnu had already killed Hiranyakashyap. So Hiranyakashyap hated Lord Vishnu. He ordered that the people around the world should worship him like God. Anyone who refused to worship him was punished to be killed. Worried by his cruel deeds, all gods went to Lord Vishnu and narrated him everything. After listening to them patiently, Lord Vishnu promised to kill him. Hiranyakashyap's son Prahlada was a big devotee of Lord Vishnu. Hiranyakashyap did not like this and decided to punish his son. He didn't provide him with food and water for many days and put him in prison. But Prahlada refused to give up his prayers. One day Lord Vishnu, with the half body of a lion and the half body of a man, emerged before Hiranyakashyap. He chased Hiranyakashyap, seated him on his lap, tore his body using his nails and killed him. Devotee Prahlada was immensely pleased to see the Lord in person and sang his glory as a true devotee. Lord Vishnu made him the new king and went back to heaven. Prahlada ruled the country for many years and continued worshipping Lord Vishnu.
Thanks for watching. Do like, share, subscribe to Sahil Bookhouse.